Everyone, it's my pleasure to be in the Kingdom Digital Transformation for the second edition. It's actually coming in a perfect timing. This week we've launched the report for the first half of the 2020. I invite everyone to visit the ndu.gov.sa website to look for the all achievements and all the efforts that have been put by all the government agencies. So far we're a lot of positive feedback, if I would say. The achievements are overwhelming. The positive feedback is making us pushing and going forward with such an effort. And most of the government agencies' efforts has been put there with a clear methodology, with a high number of customer satisfaction. And inshallah, we're looking for the second half as well by early January or second month of February. Today, I wanna be touching a bit on the leading digital transformation across diverse sectors and how actually the digital transformation as a disruptor is becoming the norm. If we look at today, the world we know is a result of key digital evolutions. Fueled by technology for huge disruption coming in. We've seen in the 1994 the bookstore disruption by Amazon. Then in 2001, we have the music industry disruption by the iPod from Apple. Then Tesla started 2003 as a fuel-powered automobile disruption. Going forward into the 2004 and 5 and 6 and the social media, until we reach today where the mobile payment by the Apple Pay and Alipay and the 2008 and 9, the hospitality. So we've seen always every 2-3 years there is a huge disruptor coming to the market, and that's actually the sector specific disruption. However, if we look into the technology side, we would see the future will be powered, at least from my point of view, by 5 main technologies. First and foremost will be the artificial intelligence. That will cover the machine learning, natural language processing, computer vision. Then we will have the IoT and edge computing, and we'll see how that will affect applications like smart cities and driverless cars, automobile. Then we would see the extended reality and where we can see medical operations done by the extended reality. We would see a visit like the 1 billion Muslims, how they can see all the activities going in the Holy Mecca and Medina by the extended reality. We would see a lot of museums changing from the current status of museum to more of a virtual museum. Then we would see the technology of the blockchain and how the blockchain it will affect the digital currencies, the smart contracts. We've seen the ECB in Europe, the European Central Bank, a lot of countries, they're talking today about the digital currencies backed by government. And then finally, we would see the robotics, the industrial revolution 4.0, 3D printing, etc. And we've seen that also in the pandemic, how the robotics help reducing the contact between human and machine. So the current era of digital transformation has disrupted the way organization work and operate. And we've seen that in many areas within the workplace. We've seen the disruption happening in the workplace, in the workforce, and in the work itself. A few numbers just to highlight how this affect positively in terms of jobs for the technology. We expect there will be 133 million new jobs created or related to the technology. We assume that 55% there will be an increase in demand for technology skills by 2030. And today there is a 16% fall in demand for physical and manual skills, and that's definitely replaced by automation and technology. So the slogan here, if I would say, is the advancement in technology have reduced the human to human collaboration to be more into human machine collaboration. In the workforce itself, we've seen how the nature of work has changed. The sharing economy, the gig work, is the new norm. We believe that around 445 billion US dollars by 2030, and this is on the doors, will be the size of the gig economy. And you've seen that today, even in the government practices sometimes, inspection or other jobs, other governments are starting to see, how can I replace the full-time jobs to more into a gig economy job where I don't need that much skilled workers, but things like design, like translation, some financial activities that I could use a gig economy or a gig worker to help me in hourly basis or on a task basis that I don't need to hire a full-time job. On the workplace itself, we've seen how workers in, for example, US or Australia or Canada, they regard themselves as a remote workers. The new, I would say, phrase, what they call the digital nomad, is a lot of people today, they want to enjoy the world, they want to travel, they want to not stay in one country or in one city or even one house. So that digital nomad phrase is basically how those skilled workers in the technology domain, they work anywhere from the world, but they can deliver the highest capability or the highest quality of jobs. And also we've seen a lot of capability from different countries. They can access online education. They can have as good as Stanford, as good as Harvard graduates, and they are from different kind of countries or from different kind of industries where they can really compete with all skills or all the capabilities around the world. So as organizations growing and as nationalization, or sorry, as collaboration among multinational companies is growing, so the search for the talent is not necessarily today associated in a geography or in a country. So the whole world it will be my search engine for talent. So in a nutshell, the digital transformation, it will be the key enabler for the whole world and also for achieving KSA vision. If you look at the KSA, we have in the digital transformation unit, we've established or we've launched the National Digital Transformation Strategy. We're focusing on seven main streamlines: the digital education, the e-health, safety and security, culture, smart cities, e-commerce, and industries and logistics. And we've seen this, we believe that 80% of the growth in the digital transformation will be coming from those industries. We have more than 55 initiatives planned under those sectors. However, the infrastructure is going hand in hand with the verticals. If I look at it today as a strategy house, I would have verticals on sectors. However, we would see horizontally as important the infrastructure, the AI and data, the smart government, all of those need to be as par or as equal to the importance of the sectors. We believe around 211 billion Saudi riyals will be the impact of the digital economy by 2025. And we believe also there will be more than 150 spillover jobs. We've seen today how applications like Mersul, like Uber, Kareem, and others, even the one that they have, freelance.sa, that's been launched by Ministry of Human Resources and Social Development, how those initiatives or activities are creating more jobs than we expected in terms of a gig economy or gig workers. But in particular, there is in every organization or every government, you always have the challenge of resistance. And the resistance always comes from traditional businesses, from traditional people, from bureaucrats and everywhere. However, when the biggest fast-tracked digital disruptor coming in, which is basically the COVID-19, we believe that everyone today had the ability and had the knowledge and has the power to believe that the COVID-19 and the digital transformation is the end goal and the ultimate goal for every organization. Or seen industries from online groceries, gaming, food delivery, video streaming. They took advantage of the pandemic. They grew by 50, 60, 70%. And we've seen also organizations, our businesses in the fitness, in the lodging, in the airlines, they have also negatively affected by the pandemic. In Saudi specifically, we've seen a growth in the retail. As an example, we've seen 200 billion spending through delivery application during the pandemic, and everyone knows how innovative solution the country and the government in Saudi Arabia, they've changed the food delivery or the grocery delivery to be and restaurant delivery to be a grocery delivery during the pandemic. We've seen 250 increase in orders in the first half of 2020.